Back here live in Washington, D.C., I'm Brooke Baldwin. The big question is why? Why did a 66-year-old man with obviously some serious grievances come down from Illinois here to Washington, D.C. and try to shoot up these Republicans practicing baseball this morning? We don't know the answer to that yet. What we do have now is a closer picture of what exactly happened. I'm going to show some video to you. It was shot by Noah Nathan, who happened to be passing by this ballpark early this morning. Roll it.
Do we know where he's at? Do we know where he's at?
He's behind home plate. If you call 911,
I assume people have been calling 911 already. Hey, is that guy okay out there? The guy, has that guy been shot? Is he okay? Is anybody talking to him?
Hearing all that gunfire gives you an indication of how long this lasted this morning in Alexandria, Virginia, at this baseball park. And you see the people taking cover. You hear some of the voices. Oh, they asked about that guy who was down. That guy, Congressman Steve Scalise, the Louisiana Republican, he was hit by the gunfire in his hip. We know he is just out of surgery after that shooting this morning. Let's go and get an update on his condition among all the other survivors as well. I've got Brian Todd standing by outside of MedStar Washington Hospital Center and Diane Gallagher outside of George Washington University Hospital. But Brian, to you first, just on Congressman Scalise's condition, out of surgery, how is he?
Well, Brooke, we're just told by hospital officials that Congressman Scalise is in critical condition. after having emerged from surgery a short time ago. He was brought here in critical condition, they say, and he remains in critical condition. It is the most severe condition that someone can be in this situation while hospitalized, according to the American Hospital Association. It means that vital signs are unstable and not within normal limits, and the patient may be unconscious. Those are the guidelines for being in critical condition. According to a Scalise aide who spoke to Armanu Raju, it's not clear if he's going to have a second surgery, but he did emerge from surgery in critical condition. That's where he remains at this hour, Brooke. Another person, another victim of the shooting, is also being treated here at MedStar Washington Hospital Center. That person's name has not been released. We're told that person is in good condition. So those are the updates from here. Congressman Scalise was medevaced in a helicopter here earlier today, landing on a pad just to my left over here. You've had security personnel and members of Congress and their staffs coming in these doors behind me all day long to check on Congressman Scalise. Also, his aides tell us that his wife Jennifer and their two young children are on their way up to Washington from New Orleans to be with him. Congressman Scalise, according to the witness accounts, was struck in the hip, as you just mentioned. According to Senator Jeff Flake, the Republican senator who was there at the baseball field, he was motionless on the field for a while the shooting was going on. He dragged himself maybe about 15 yards into the outfield. He was struck while he was at the second base position on that field. He dragged himself into the outfield, then lay motionless, and people couldn't get to him for a little while until the shooting stopped. But they did get to him. They transported him off the field. Senator Jeff Flake said that he grabbed Congressman Scalise's cell phone and called his wife to tell her the news as all that was happening. And then we're told by Congressman Scalise's staff that he was in good spirits when he got here and that he spoke to his wife on the phone before surgery. Then he had surgery for a few hours, came out of it, is now in critical condition. Brooke, unclear if he's going to have a second surgery.
Well, we wish his family safe travels as they undoubtedly are trying to get up here from New Orleans as quickly as they possibly can. Brian Todd, thank you so much on both of those updates. Diane, let me ask you a similar question on some of these survivors updates. But before I do, we did just get a statement in. This is the family of one of the victims. This is Matt Mica's family saying, quote, baseball is one of his great passions, and he has always loved the congressional team. Matt's family, now traveling to Washington, D.C., was informed by paramedics on the scene that Matt was shot multiple times, is in critical condition, and is currently in surgery at an area hospital. So there you have it from the family. Diane, to you at GW Hospital on Mica. What are you hearing?
Yeah, and Brooke, Matt Mica has been in critical condition since he was brought here to GW Hospital. From some of the congressmen and senators out on the scene, they describe Micah's injuries as some of the worst of those victims out there. Two of the people were brought here to GW. Since then, we've been getting updates. His condition has not changed. You know, you mentioned his love of baseball there that his family talked about. Matt Mica was there helping those congressmen, helping those senators get ready for that game tomorrow. He was just sort of working with them, training. His family said he always loved the congressional baseball team. He was a former staffer on the Hill and had moved on to lobbying. He worked for Tyson Foods, and they'd issued a statement early this morning after the shooting saying that, of course, their thoughts and prayers were with the Mica family. His condition has not changed, though, again, Brooke, since he came here in critical condition. One of those two patients, the other one being the shooter, of course, they brought those ambulances out when my photographer Jay got here. They were sort of washing the blood off of those gurneys, cleaning out the ambulances at that time. Again, they said that he'd been shot multiple times. You can only imagine how that family must have felt in Michigan getting that phone call from those paramedics out there, thinking their son was just someone out there helping those congressmen and women perfect their baseball skills, doing something that he loved, not expecting any sort of phone call like that. Again, as you said, they are on their way here to Washington, D.C. We will try to let you know once we are told they have arrived.
Not a day any of these family members, let alone members of Congress, as they've been saying, would have expected, you know, practicing 7 in the morning in Alexandria. Diane, thank you so much. And we should also mention the game will go on as planned tomorrow night here in Washington, D.C. at Washington National Stadium. With me now to talk about all of this, Jonathan Wackrow, former Secret Service agent and CNN law enforcement analyst, Andre Guillerme, former U.S. Capitol Police officer, and Dan Emmett, retired Secret Service agent and author of I Am a Secret Service Agent. So good to see all of you all. Andre, to you first. You know, the only reason